Good morning. Welcome to Malayali Soul Channel. I am Sajeev Vishwanathan. Today date 13th October 2021, Wednesday. Main headings from Indian Express, published from Thiruvananthapuram. Two details states among three dates as rain latches state. Dam status up. Heavy rain triggered by cyclonic storms that formed over the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea continues to last state on Tuesday. Three people, including two little sisters, died in rain-related incidents in Malappuram and Kollam. Several low-lying areas were inundated, while minor landslides were reported in northern districts. Shutters of many dams were raised. Nearly 700 people have been shifted to the 27 relief camps so far. Liana Fatima, 7, and her 7-month-old sister, Lubana, from Mathakulam near Karipur in Malappuram, died on Tuesday morning when the bedroom wall of their house collapsed on them. They were sleeping alongside mother Sumaya. Faculty data fudge at Government Medical College too. New Delhi alarmed at reports that government medical colleges have started data fudging to show higher faculty count. The center has asked all colleges to share details of vacancies in all departments immediately. Till now, the Malays was restricted to Dorji Private Medical College. In a letter issued at all government medical colleges in the country on Monday, assessed by this newspaper, the National Medical Commission asked them for these details within 24 hours. There are about 275 government medical colleges in India at present. Covaxin safe for 2+ age group, says expert panel. New Delhi. Bharat Biotech's Covaxin can be administered on adolescents and children as young as 2 years, and expert panel of India's apex drug regulator has recommended. The final approval by the Drug Controller General of India is expected soon, so said. All data related to the clinical trials in the 2 to 17 years age group has been submitted to the Central Drug Standard Control Organization and the Subject Expert Committee, Bharat Biotech said in a statement on Tuesday. All India related to the clinical trials in the 2 to 17 years age group has been submitted to the Central Drugs Standard Control Organization and the Subject Expert Committee, Bharat Biotech said in a statement on Tuesday. This represents one of the first approval worldwide for COVID-19 vaccine for the 2 to 18 age group, said the company. We now await further regulatory approvals from the CDSCO prior to product launch and make availability of Covaxin for children. Rachel Sella, a clinic lead of COVID vaccine at the company, said in the tweet that Covaxin has been reported to be safe and immunogenic in a pediatric cohort, and the approval in children will help expedite the reopening of schools. Modi comes down on a selective fury, says it damages human rights. In New Delhi, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday hit out at selective outrage by a section of the people, saying political opportunism causes maximum damage to human rights. While he did not identify the people who were weighing violations of human rights on the scale of political gains and losses, his remarks assumed significance in the backdrop of the Lucking Poor Kerry violence. For the BJP then launched a blistering attack on the Congress for overlooking atrocities against members of the scheduled castes in Rajasthan. Modi was speaking at the 20th Foundation for Ceremony on the National Human Rights Commission. Hours later, the BJP held a pressure to show video clippings of violence against members of the scheduled castes in Congress-ruled Rajasthan. Referring to Modi's remarks earlier in the day, BJP National General Secretary Dushyant Gautam said his Modi anguish is justified since the victims of the Rajasthan violence want the Congress leader Rahul Gandhi to show similar solidarity with them as he has been doing UP's Lucking Poor Kerry. Since UP is heading for poll, Congress leaders are trooping into Lucking Poor Kerry while ignoring similar atrocities elsewhere, he charged. The BJP broadside came a day after his top leadership brainstormed his strategy for UP, while the party had earlier hoped that the Lucknow would be handled locally. The escalating political heat forced the top brass to lead the attack. Who allowed flagpoles everywhere? High Court. Kochi. Coming down heavily on the practice of political parties erecting flagpoles in public places, the Kerala High Court on Tuesday directed the state government to inform it about the steps being taken to remove such unauthorized poles. Justice Devan Ramachandran issued the directive on a petition filed in Mannam Sugar Mills Cooperative Limited, Pandalam, seeking to remove the flag poles erected by various trade unions before the mills gates. The court observed that flag poles could be seen in every nook and cranny in the state. These are even lead to law and order problem. Hence, the government should take stringent action against this practice. The court said it has failed to understand under what authority such poles are being erected on roadsides and public places. In fact, the situation in the state is such that any organization can erect flag poles at public places. If a common man erects a flagpole, action is taken against the person. However, when established institutions and political organizations do it, no action is taken against them. The court noted that erection of flagpoles in public places is against the land conservancy law. If some people erect a post on the roadside, then there is political allegiance attached to it. If someone asks them to shift it to another place, there are fines saying someone has removed the flag. They erect flag posts wherever they want to, the court observed already. The court implicated the secretary, local self-government institutions as a respondent and posted the case to further hearing to November 1st. Curbs of domestic flies at full capacity from October 18. New Delhi, from October 18, domestic flights can operate without any capacity restrictions. The center set on Tuesday, currently the domestic carriers can operate only up to 85% of their pre-COVID services. After review of the current status of scheduled domestic operations, which passenger demand for air travel in terms of the purpose specified in the initial order dated May 21st, 2020, it has been decided to restore the scheduled domestic air operations with effect from 18th October 2021 without any capacity restrictions. Read the order issued by the Civil Aviation Ministry. With the gradual decline in cases, airports across the country are recording heavy rush. Delhi High Court clears Rakesh Asthana's appointment. New Delhi, the Delhi High Court has dismissed a PIL challenging Rakesh Asthana's appointment as Delhi Police Commissioner 4 days before his supernatural on July 31st, saying there was no illegality. Murder victim Jayarajan told IUML men exonerated. Kannur, the Kannur Additional Sessions Court has exonerated 12 Muslim League workers accused of attacking CPM leader P. Jayarajan at Ariel near Talikparamba in 2012. The trial of two others cast in pending PFOI. Congress list delay blamed on Casey's bid to dilute criterion, woman likely to lose out. Thiruvananthapuram, AICC General Secretary Kesu Venugopal met reporters in New Delhi on Tuesday and denied reports that his insistence on including a couple of nominees was delaying the finalization of the list of state official bearers. The unusual move by the leader followed widespread rumors among Congress rank and file that MB Vincent and U. Rajivan, former district Congress chiefs of Thrissur and Kozhikode, would find a place in the list, violating all norms. Sources told TNIE that Venugopal had suggested recommending Vincent and Rajivan in the list through the norms was against nominating first presidents of district committee. Venugopal wanted to use the relaxation given to Padmaja Venugopal and Bindu Krishna in the case of these leaders as well. The cases of Padmaja and Bindu were taken up to ensure fair representation of women leaders. There was no point in relaxing that exemption further, said a senior leader. The position taken by State Congress President K. Sudhakaran and opposition leader V.D. Satheesan against relaxing norms to accommodate Vincent and Rajivan is now set to diminish the chances of the women leaders. It is learned that by Tuesday night, the senior leaders reached an understanding to stick to the criteria decided by the Political Affairs Committee meeting. The effort is to finalize the list of 51-member state committee listed by Wednesday. It is learned Sudhakaran is not keen to listen to Venugopal's demand, as Vincent is one of the 97 leaders who have been served a notice for the party's dismal show in the recent assembly election. These are the main headings from the front page of Indian Express today. Thank you. Thank you for watching.